السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, today is the day of Arafah, one of the greatest days of the year. And this day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said about this day, that the one who fasts on this day, that Allah ta'ala will forgive for them their previous sins of the year that passed and the sins of the year to come. A, meaning the minor. So brothers and sisters, during this day, is a day that we should not be wasting our time. Is a day that we should be busying ourselves with the worship of Allah. And we only have a few hours left of the day. So brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, the dua that the believer is to make during the day of Arafah is La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. That the Prophet commanded us to constantly say, La ilaha illallah. And this kalima, La ilaha illallah, is kalimatul tawheed. And it is the kalima of success. This kalima, La ilaha illallah, is the key to paradise. And it will protect the person from the hellfire. Whoever dies upon this kalima, he has succeeded. Whoever dies living firm upon La ilaha illallah, he has succeeded in the dunya, in the grave, and in the hereafter. And whoever dies upon other than La ilaha illallah, then his abode will be the hellfire for eternity. Na'am, this kalima, La ilaha illallah, is the reason why Allah ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, and the human and the jinn. La ilaha illallah. So the Muslim loves this kalima, lives by this kalima, and strives to die by this kalima. Na'am. And what is the meaning of La ilaha illallah? This is the kalima that all the prophets and the messengers called to. From Adam to Nuh, to Ibrahim, to Musa, all of them called to La ilaha illallah. As Allah ta'ala, he said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ الرَّسُولِ أَنِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتِ. Verily, we have sent to every nation a messenger, calling them to worship Allah and stay away from the false deities. Ay, La ilaha illallah. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not come with anything new. Rather, this is the call of all the prophets and the messengers. And what is the meaning of La ilaha illallah? If this is your key to paradise, do you know what it means? Do you know what the conditions are? Do you know what the pillars are? Brothers and sisters, this is your key to paradise. What is the meaning of La ilaha illallah? The meaning of La ilaha illallah is La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. That there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. Ay? No one worthy of worship. La ilaha illallah does not mean that there is no God except Allah. It does not mean that there is no creator except Allah. Why? Because at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the disbelievers who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fought against, they believed that Allah was the creator alone. And they believed that Allah was the sustainer alone. That Allah had no partner in this. Allah says, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. And if you were to ask them, who created the heavens and the earth, the disbelievers, they would have said, Allah. So why is it that they, even though they believe in Allah, when they died, they entered into the hellfire for eternity? Because they refused to single out Allah in worship. And this is the call of La ilaha illallah. That there is none worthy of worship except Allah. Na'am, brothers and sisters. And one might ask, Allah Ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, the sun and the moon, the human and the jinn, everything because of this kalima. Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah says, verily I have created the human and the jinn only to worship me. La ilaha illallah. There's none worthy of worship except Allah. Na'am, brothers and sisters. So one might ask, what is the significance of La ilaha illallah? Why? What is the significance of worship? Why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command that whoever worships other than Allah, his abode will be the hellfire for eternity? Why? Because worshiping Allah alone, this is a right of Allah over us. This is Allah's right over us. Na'am. He created us. He sustained us. He has given us everything that we need. So is He not deserving of our worship? Na'am. He alone is deserving of our worship. So if we worship anyone other than Allah, then we have oppressed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to Mu'adh, أَتَدْرِ مَا حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ وَمَا حَقُّ الْعِبَادِ عَلَى اللَّهِ. The Prophet said, O Mu'adh, do you know what is the right of Allah over His servants? And what is the servant's right over Allah? So Mu'adh said, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger knows best. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, the right of Allah over His servants is that they worship Him alone, not associating any partners with Him. This is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. And the right of the servants over Allah is that he does not enter into the hellfire, anyone who dies upon La ilaha illallah. Brothers and sisters, La ilaha illallah. Whoever dies upon other than La ilaha illallah, no matter how much money they have, no matter how much success they have in the eye, that which the eye can see, they are losers and they are failures. Why? Because the dunya is temporary. The dunya is temporary and the hereafter is eternity. Na'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. By time, Allah is swearing, all of mankind is in loss. And then Allah Ta'ala makes an exception. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Except those who believe and do righteous deeds. Na'am. If you are other than, if you are upon other than La ilaha illallah, then you are in loss. Why are you in loss? Regardless how much you have from the dunya, regardless how beautiful you look, regardless what car you drive, you are in loss because this dunya is temporary. And the ultimate loss is to enter into the hellfire for eternity. And if you die upon other than La ilaha illallah, that is your abode. We ask Allah protection from that. Likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. The Prophet said, Allah does not look at how you physically look, nor does He look at how much money you have. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. But rather Allah Ta'ala, He looks at your heart and your actions. Na'am, how beautiful you look, what car you drive, how much houses you have, that doesn't oppress Allah. Allah, He is al-Razzaq, He gave it to you. How can that oppress Allah when He has given it to you? But rather that which brings the servant closer to Allah is him rectifying his heart with La ilaha illallah. Verily the only way to purify your heart is through La ilaha illallah. And this is what Allah Ta'ala will look at in the Day of Judgment. وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, as we have explained, that if you are upon other than La ilaha illallah and you die upon it, then you will lose. Then you are from those who Allah says, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. All of mankind are in loss. And if you are from those who hold on to La ilaha illallah, live by La ilaha illallah, then you are from the exception that Allah says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Except those who believe and do righteous actions. May Allah Ta'ala make us from them. Look, brothers and sisters, Fir'aun, who had the kingdom underneath him. Musa alayhi salam was calling him to La ilaha illallah. And Fir'aun refused. He was astonished by his beauties of the dunya. And he refused the call of La ilaha illallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated Fir'aun. None of his wealth helped him. None of the dunya can save you from the protection of Allah. Na'am. So Allah ta'ala made the oceans swallow him. Likewise, Abu Lahab and Abu Talib. Abu Talib, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who loved the Prophet and who loved the Muslims. Look, he even believed that the Quran was the speech of Allah. And he believed that the Prophet was truthful. But he refused to say La ilaha illallah. Even though he believed it was the truth, he refused to say it and utter it. So when he died, Allah Ta'ala, he said, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Verily you do not guide whom you love, but Allah guides whom He wills. For verily Allah Ta'ala, He is the one who guides the heart to La ilaha illallah. And when Allah Ta'ala loves a person, He opens his heart to accepting La ilaha illallah. Na'am. So Abu Talib, when he refused to say La ilaha illallah, and he died upon other than La ilaha illallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that his punishment is that he will be in the hellfire for eternity, and he will stand on a coal. And the coal will be so hot that it will boil his brain. May Allah Ta'ala protect us from the hellfire. And he will be in this punishment for eternity. And he will think that this is the least punishment. He will think that it is the worst punishment, when in reality it is the least punishment. All of this because he refused to say La ilaha illallah. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he would tell his people, Ya qawm, قولوا لا إله إلا الله تفلحوا. Oh my people, say لا إله إلا الله, you will succeed. Because if you hold on to لا إله إلا الله, this is success. This is your key to Jannah. Na'am, do you not know that this is the greatest blessing on the face of this earth? That Allah Ta'ala guides a person to لا إله إلا الله. This is greater than the dunya and everything within it, that Allah opens your heart to La ilaha illallah. Do not be deceived, brothers and sisters. Show gratitude for this blessing, because the ulama have said the greatest blessing on the face of this earth is that Allah guides your heart to La ilaha illallah. Because Allah only guides the hearts of the people whom He loves to La ilaha illallah. And those whom He hates, He closes their hearts from La ilaha illallah. Look, brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said about this statement. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, man qala la ilaha illallah sidqan min qalbihi dakhala al-jannah. That whosoever says la ilaha illallah truthfully from his heart, he will enter into paradise. Ay, that his abode will be paradise. May Allah Ta'ala make us from them. So those who live by la ilaha illallah, and they stay away from the sins, and they fulfill the obligations. And if they fall into a sin, they repent. These are those who have completed Tawheed. Then they will enter into paradise without reckoning or without punishment. May Allah Ta'ala make us from them. These are the people who have completed Tawheed and La ilaha illallah. Ay, those who fulfill the obligations. They stay away from the prohibitions. And if they commit a prohibition, they repent. These are the people who will enter into paradise without reckoning and without punishment. As for those who die upon La ilaha illallah, they believe in La ilaha illallah, but they die upon sin, then they will be under the mashi'ah, the will of Allah. If Allah Ta'ala wills, He will forgive them for their sins. And if Allah Ta'ala wills, He will enter them into the hellfire in accordance to their sin and then they will be removed from the hellfire, and their abode will be paradise. So brothers and sisters, the virtues of La ilaha illallah, it is the key to paradise. And do not be deceived. Do not think that you can say La ilaha illallah and not pray. Do not think that you can say La ilaha illallah and do all the haram. Rather, from the rights of La ilaha illallah is that you follow it up with action. Na'am. These are those who truly love La ilaha illallah and implement La ilaha illallah. As for those who merely say it with their tongue and they do not follow it with any action, we fear that La ilaha illallah will not benefit them. May Allah Ta'ala protect us from that. Likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَى النَّارِ مَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ يَبْتَغِي بِذَٰلِكَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, that Allah had made haram, the hellfire, for the person who says La ilaha illallah and he seeks by it the face of Allah. Look, Allah has made the hellfire haram for this person who says La ilaha illallah, seeking by it the face of Allah. And his abode will be Jannah, because La ilaha illallah is the key to paradise. Na'am, likewise, from the virtues and the benefits of La ilaha illallah, Musa alayhi salam, he said to Allah, Oh Allah, teach me a kalima. He said, Allimni shay'an adhkuruka wa ad'uka bih. Musa said to Allah in the hadith, Oh Allah, teach me a statement that I can call upon you to and I can remember you with. So Allah Ta'ala, he said to Musa, Ya Musa, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Allah says, Oh Musa, say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So Musa alayhi salam, he says, Ya Rabb, كُلُّ عِبَادِكَ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا. So Musa says, Oh Allah, all of your servants say La ilaha illallah. So Allah Ta'ala, he said, Ya Musa, لو أن السماوات السبع وعامرهن غيري والأرضين السبع في كفة ولا إله إلا الله في كفة مالت بهن لا إله إلا الله. So Allah Ta'ala, he told Musa, Oh Musa, if the entire seven heavens and the entire seven earths were in a scale, were in the pan of a scale, where in one side of the scale, Allah ilaha illallah was in the other side of the scale, then verily la ilaha illallah would outweigh the other, everything in the heavens and the earth, showing the blessing of la ilaha illallah. And this is why, brothers and sisters, we see many people, they complain and complain over dunya affairs. I'm going through money problems. I'm going through family problems. I'm going through this and that. What blessing do I have? Do you not know that you have been bestowed the greatest blessing on the face of this earth? That Allah Ta'ala had granted you and opened your heart to La ilaha illallah? That is the key to paradise? Na'am. Do you not know the magnitude, the value of this blessing? Be careful from being ungrateful. Because if you are ungrateful of this blessing, Allah Ta'ala can take it away from you and misguide your heart. May Allah Ta'ala protect us from that. نعم واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأقيم الصلاة. Keep the line straight as possible. Ankle to ankle, shoulder to shoulder. We remind the brothers and the sisters, today at Maghrib time, we have iftar for the community, for all the brothers and sisters to attend. We encourage everyone to come out. Likewise, there's the Usul al-Thalatha class after Salat al-Maghrib. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. الله سمع الله لمن حمدا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. الله سمع الله لمن حمدا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We remind everyone that today is the day of Arafah. Of course, the day ends at Maghrib time, so try to take advantage of these few hours that we have. Don't waste it. Again, the dhikr that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, we say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Keep repeating this. Likewise, make dua, make lots of dua on the day of Arafah. For verily the dua made